Hey there. You're watching the Jessa Channel on YouTube. I'm Jessa, and today I am here with more villagers. In the last episode, we had some hope brought back to our beleaguered village of Jessaville. We had to move everyone yet again to the hills, to the mountains, actually, where we discovered stone and iron deposits, but we did not discover any water. Therefore, we needed to collect rain through this rain catcher. And since the game was released last week, there have been two patches already, and one of the things that I was mentioning that would be really neat if they had was a way to remove a building, and boom, there's now a removal feature. So you can remove a building and place it. Now, being of course the simmer that I am, I wanna like pick the entire building up like a lot and move it over here, but you can't do that. Also, they have lowered the speed to 8 speed here, 4 speed, 2 speed. So there's some changes. There's some crashing changes as well too. I haven't had any problems with crashing, but some people definitely were. And we need to look and see what we need to do. We need to communicate to Ewalt to build a mine over the tunnel shaft, which we've done. So we've done everything in the notebook here. So I think it's just a waiting game. Again, because I believe the next part of our story was that, how are we doing here on stone and iron? We have enough stone, so I don't have anyone in our stone mill right now. In our iron mine, we have one miner. Yeah, so things are going on nicely. And finally, Hun over here, who is here at the barn, our little barn area here. Such a cute little place. Anyway, he's working furiously and he comes up to let us know about it. He tells us his hands are already raw and dry from the work in the strange mountain air. He hasn't managed to save all the weakened livestock. Oh, unfortunately, some of the animals died. The journey into the mountain, it seems like, was too much. What are we going to do if Jeanette doesn't return? That's what we're waiting for, is Jeanette went down in the last episode, our scout. Went down into, I think, the iron mine or the one of these two places where we found some tunnels in the mountains. There's no way we'll manage to find our way through the mountains without her. But we have no choice to keep going. It's true. So, in my wisdom, I say we have no choice but to keep going. And that is true. So, in the meantime, let's see if there's anything we can build. I think maybe it might be kind to finally build some houses. Look at our poor villagers. How pitiful is that? oh, we can build a bridge, but we have nothing to build a bridge over. Let's build a bridge over a mountainside. Oh, or never mind. I guess we're not getting houses. So the settlers were tired, exhausted. Work had become significantly harder. When Augustus finally sent word that the king didn't need any more resources, the people felt so empty, cut off, useless? No. Exactly. Oh, actually, yes, exactly, because that's what else were we supposed to do? Go back to the swamp? Oh, we're definitely not going back to the swamp. In the last episode, we had our difficulty in the swamp. There was this terrible fog. Our town hall went swimming. It was dreadful. So stay in the mountains and slowly but surely starve to death because our livestock aren't doing well. Hopelessness is a slippery slope. Excuse me. Let's try that again. Hopelessness is a slippery slope. From a will to live to self-abandonment. Wise words, my dear bard. So, Jekyllin continues on with the story, letting us know about it. And then, finally, one day, Jessa is out looking over Jessaville, and she turns and sees a bedraggled figure. Here comes Janeef, our scout. Is it the dirt on my clothing and face? She says it's been days since I last saw my reflection in the mirror. I probably wouldn't even recognize myself. Look at her, she's all filthy. I can't tell you how pleased I am to see you. I could do with a long, hot soak in the tub. I think Jessa and Janeth might have a little crush on each other. I'm just reading into things, but maybe. Jessa offers her tub, her queenly tub, of which we don't really have one. I've got good news. An extremely complicated mind system. In the extremely complicated mind system, I actually managed to find a path through the other side of the mind. Jeremias, our priest, jumps in. He says, "You're a godsend. How can we leave this awful, unholy place?" I'm so happy I'm getting tears in my eyes. I say, "Let's get the biggest tub and the best herbs we have." Excuse me. Pardon me. Janeth deserves the best bath of all time. So we dunk her in the pig trough and call it a day. A bath. Oh, Jekyll, what a great idea. You can't leave me alone with all this booze in here. Okay, are you guys getting the impression that Jekyll is a bit of a boozer? Because I am. Okay, hey, all right, so we have success. So it looks like Janeth has come back through the mountains, and we are going to be taking our travelers, weary, footsore, through the mines. Let's find out what happens. This loading screen, and I can't speak today, lets us know that our villagers will blah, blah, blah. That's what it lets us know. Because I can't speak and I can't read. This is going to be a great episode. Are we getting to the part where Jessa and her community find the abandoned settlement? Ooh, an abandoned settlement. Jekyll urges Ursel to stop ruining the story. Let's talk about what happened when we went through the tunnel. But that part is so depressing and eerie, going through the tunnel. Only if you order me another ale, Jekyll says. Ursel's keeping her man in check. You heartless woman. But all right, have it your way. When we stepped out into the open after they traveled through the mine, they could hardly believe their eyes. I imagine that it was much like that long trek through the mines of Moria, except without that scary monster and Gandalf. At the foot of the mountains, there was an abundance of fertile and wonderful land. Spring had just begun, and the hues of green from the rich landscape were simply dazzling. Oh, it's a beautiful sight to our weary eyes. We've been traveling in darkness. At first, the sun hurts as it goes into our eyes, so unused to light. But when they walked a few feet further, they made a strange discovery. Oh no! And it tells us a building site is not reachable by our workers, but I'm not the one who put it there. But they're still building on them. Okay, so Benlin comes in, our advisor. And he says, what are my tired eyes seeing? Are those abandoned homes? A whole village, but there's not a single soul around. However, there are no bodies to be found, and some belongings are missing, too.
The building is finished.
Oh, wow. Look at that. Quick. I'm gonna, go down. Look at that. Before we even finish the story, our villagers, hardy, got things busy. A whole village, so it seems, but there isn't a single soul around. There are no bodies to be found. Some belongings are missing. It looks as if the former inhabitants made a run for it. Oh, I don't like this at all. Only a madman would leave such nice houses behind, and in what excellent condition. I don't like this at all. Not at all. I'm going to assign a pharmacist while I'm here. Might as well get people working. And here's a warehouse. So we'll put, I don't know if we need three warehousers. Let's just go with one. And also, while we're at it, we'll just head over here and get some gathering going. I'll tell them to gather stone and trees. This is a very nice little hamlet, but the fact that it's just empty and sitting there, well, I'll tell you, it makes me a bit nervous. Anyway, only a madman would leave such nice houses behind. With a bit of work, we could easily get them back up to scratch. Do you intend to use these houses? Well, certainly I do. A house doesn't equal a home. I'd say it's more a case of them borrowing them until someone comes and claims them back. We've managed to obtain a few houses without any effort whatsoever on our part, because last time, in the last chapter, our residents actually never got a place to live. Oh, look at this! There's baby making going on, finally! Boom shakalaka, get down with it. They probably don't need their queen staring in the window and encouraging them on. Probably not a good thing. Okay, so, Basalt has a bad feeling about this. I do too. Given the imminent repair work, a sawmill would be very useful to us. It'd allow us to quickly processing trees we cut down, and the increased wood supply would make a great advantage. So, we have a new quest to make a sawmill. We need 45 pieces of wood, so it's a good thing I set them to wood making. There's some trees that for some reason we can't get to, but I will use the shift key here. The developers in the patch today answered a lot of the requests that we had, the community has given them as far as suggestions. And one of them is when placing a house, let's see if we have one here. So with a small house here before, you couldn't zoom in or out. Now if you hold the shift button key, you can zoom in and zoom out, so you can actually turn it the way you want to. A great addition. So thank you very much to Bumblebee for doing that. And Tassilo, particularly Tassilo Raw, is the leader of Bumblebee, the head of Bumblebee in the design team, developer team, and has come and watched at least one video I know of. So if you are watching, Tassilo, thank you for listening to what we need. Okay, so anyway, I need to talk to you about something, says Ewalt. It's a bit embarrassing. If it has to do, Ewalt, with what was going on in that house right there, I don't want to know about it. We've known each other so long, I say. Spit it out. All your villagers have been in great spirits, and with spring coming and their new home, well, it's made them very well merry. Oh, do we get to make a tavern now? Oh, well, you know, lustful. Well, I've noticed. I love that there are actually hearts going on over the trees, the house when they're making whoopee. Lustful? Excuse me? I don't quite follow. Okay. I know that maybe I haven't got a lot of brains in my head, but I know what lustful means. I'll explain it to you with a gesture. Look. Like bunny rabbits! Oh, I say, I'm finally catching on. I think that my character here, maybe she's never had any, you know, lustfulness. Look, it's going on again! Really? I told you to go out to the woods and look at what you're doing. Well, at least you're not doing it in the woods. Extended buildings will help us house our children. So, we have, we can add an extension. We are missing some stone and iron, so we better get started on making an iron here. We could also do a fishing jetty too, which I'm going to put right here. And that will help us get some fish. And I'll also put down some hunter's lodges, but well, I just screwed up. I'm gonna speed up time again to get these trees going is what I need here. Whoops, sorry about that. Let go of the mouse for a minute. And let's get a better view if we can. So I posted today on Mod the Sims about how this game reminded me so much of a little medieval Sims 2, so I'm hoping that some of the old Sims players out there, and if you're still watching, you know, as always, I'm so glad you're still here at the channel.
The building is finished.
Oh, and look, there's symbols that come up that show you when you're building. Now, that's neat. They've made a lot of good changes. I'm impressed. How much the game is just reminds me of a medieval Sims 2. And one suggestion that I have, if any of the developer team is watching, and I'm also going to email them, but I think it would be wonderful. Let's just grab a villager, any random villager like this one. So this is Lisa, and I'm going to pause for a minute. It would be great if we could change Lisa's name and we could name her whatever we wanted, because I think naming, and that's one of the things that we've learned from playing the XCOM game, is how much more attached you get to the people in your game when you can give them a name. And when you've named your soldiers and you've given them a biography and they, you know, you've watched them go from being a scared rookie all the way up to an important major, you can really feel attached to your soldiers. And I think it'd be very nice with this game if we could just name, and maybe if there was a little biography area here that popped up, we could just write a little bio. Like we could say, you know, that in the spring of the 10th year or whatever, you know, she made a baby or something like that, or she, you know, someone was born. We have this over here. Didn't mean to go there. We have this over here that gives us news of the town, but it'd be nice if we could personalize our people. So let's continue on here. I'm going to make a quarry because we need a quarry. And I just need to find a stone deposit. Ah, there we go. Okay, a quarry, and we're missing an iron mine, but we can't make the iron mine until we have stone. I really appreciate that. That shows me that they're actually in the midst of building. It makes things a lot easier to see.
The building is finished.
Okay, so we have some stone cutters. Let's get two of those. Oh, we can get four of them in here, so let's do that. Get that stone a-rolling. Rolling. And also, I'm just going to throw a hunting hide out here just to keep food going. Let's see. What do I need to expand this house again? Extending, and if there's no infant or villager inside the house. Oh, okay. So we're still, yeah, we need 10 and 5, I believe that was. They do get stone, I believe this is the stone quarry, very quickly, with four villagers in there. So now, and I'm going to go to the story in just a minute, but we need three more pieces of stone and we should be good to go. We'll put our stone quarry just over here. And there we go. I mean our iron mine. We'll put it right there. And let's continue on with the story. Jeremias tells us he has important, disconcerting news. Is it about Han? What happened to Han? Oh no, did Han have a head injury? The developers didn't tell us about that. Maybe it happened in the mines when we were going through the mountains. Jeremias assures us that Han is tougher than he looks. But we really need to start thinking about our situation and can't waste too much time licking our wounds. The villagers woke up this morning and they found disturbing red markings on the door. Uh-oh. Maybe it's the red witch that we saw in the swamp. What kind of markings? They aren't symbols. They're splashes of color that are proving really hard to wash off. Maybe it's from the bandits? The color and type of marking have similarity to ones we saw when we arrived here. Oh no, whatever happened to the previous occupants is going to happen to us. God be with us, says Jeremiah. Schultheis, we've known each other for a few months now and I've never seen you with such a pale complexion. It looks like you've seen a ghost. Jekyllin tells us the hunter sat down in a chair without saying a word and stared into the distance. And there he sat, Schultheis, a big, strong bear of a man, with a powerful stature, solid apparel, and armed for every worldly danger. But his face was empty, expressionless, as if something had taken all his character, all his inner strength, and left his body behind as an empty shell. When an experienced man like Schultheis becomes speechless, it can only mean that something unfathomably awful has happened. And while I'm speaking of unfathomably awful, let's see what happened to our... Oh, it's still being built. Okay, I'm looking out for our hunting lodge here. Jessa knew this upon seeing him. The villagers' leaders gathered around Schultheis. He had just come back from looking for children in the forest. Tears filled his eyes. Oh no! Acarius hanged all of our children? Oh my gosh! Acarius was mentioned, I think, in the first episode as being an extremely evil bandit. Oh no. It's... people are broken apart here.
The building is finished.
They wanted revenge. The villagers want revenge. Acarius has declared war on the settlers, drowning in a swamp of guilt and hate. I was? Wow, that's terrible. Jessa knew what had to be done. She invested all her resources into weapons and soldiers.
Finish the quest.
So, we have an ability here to, I guess we don't. I was going to say, in the last episode, we could assign a soldier, but we can't. So let's see.
Attention, your village is being attacked.
Oh no! Really? Shoot. Well, says Acarius, the evil bandit has arrived. Let's see where they are. Villagers, oh no. Okay, well, let's pause. Look at these people, punks. Can't see them through the trees. Oh yeah? You're gonna do the dirty on us? I don't think so. So, we have... I don't think we have... How do we fight this? We can do a bridge, a large house, a small house, pharmacy, chapel, rain watch, well. So yeah, whatever it is that we can fight this with hasn't come up yet. Anyway, let's zoom out. Here I was punishing my messenger for spreading lies. Turns out he was wrong. I was wrong and he was right. You dirty little rats have indeed set up your own army. Acarius, you evil bleepity bleep. This is your last chance to get back down, Acarius. Give up. Jessa and her people are under my protection and therefore protected by Duke Albrechtus, as well as the king himself. If you go against his majesty, will you have to face the devastating consequences? This looks like a guy who really doesn't care about devastating consequences. Oh, what a joke, as if I'd take a blind bit of notice of that. You're gonna hang from the king's battlements. And then he says something rude that we can't repeat in front of the children. Watch your mouth, says Benlin. So now they're basically facing off and swinging words. And Acarius brings up something about the faceless army here that we've been running from. There's no point in trying to negotiate with that devil spawn. He took our children. Man, you have to be crazy to hang children. That's horrible. Oh, and he called me a little strumpet. You called me a little strumpet? You're going down. Oh, yeah. Oh, no. No. See, there's a lot that I can take, but I've had it up to here. And anyone who calls me a little strumpet, let's just say, you better start running. I'll give you a head start. So, yeah, and then he goes on talking about how he hung the children, and that's really not gonna, we're just gonna skip all that stuff because it's too traumatizing. Okay, you want to fight? You can have your fight. Uh-oh. Sometimes I wish I could just leave parts of the story out, forget and bury them. The dark chapter from the life of Jessa can't be left out. It influences all her future decisions. It's true. He came to our village and he ruined us. There was a great deal of disgusting battle and whatnot. All I wanted to do was run away from the war and build a home for my people, but instead war came to us. Only after their hands were already covered in blood did the settlers recognize that fleeing was their only option, so they left their burning houses behind. Oh no. So we had to run again? And Acarius, where did he flee to? The wretched beast also left to lick his wounds. But the rage in his heart continued to burn violently and he wouldn't find any peace until he had killed Jessa. Aw, man. I don't like that. And Jacqueline doesn't either. It's all so depressing. I suddenly feel sober, says Jacqueline. There are situations where even the most detailed patterns of color can help. Where not even the most detailed patterns of color can help relieve sorrow. Oh, so that was a very quick mission. I think the only thing we did was, what did we do? We made houses, we learned how to build extensions, and a bunch of our villagers did the bump-de-bump. I mean, I'm not complaining, I'm just saying. I think this might be the last chapter of the story. I'm not sure. Let's see. So spring is here, but first, let's head out to the main menu. I'm going to actually save really quickly right here. But I'm just curious to see if our story is almost done. Don't remember what episode we're on. I think we're on 4. Two more to go. We're on chapter 4, chapter 5, and chapter 6. A long rocky road. No, we finished chapter 4, so we're about to do chapter 5 and chapter 6. But it looks like this chapter 5 is interesting. It's called Ship Ahoy. So I say we head on in and find out if we get to sail a ship. That'd be cool. All right. So this is nice. Oh, listen to the ocean. That's gorgeous. One of the complaints that I've seen in the game, if you head over to you're watching this and you said, this game looks really fun, I'm gonna head over to Steam. Right now, the Steam reviews for the game the game is not being reviewed fairly. Because people are saying that it's a Banished clone, Banished being another game. And I don't agree with that. I think it has its own little charm. So this is a nice cove here, and oh, look at it, bunny rabbit. The little bunny rabbit, so cute. Yes, I'm like an important queen, and you know, I ride in my horse, and I'm like, now we will begin to settle here. Oh my God, look at the little bunny rabbit. He's so cute. We need to carry on telling the story. What happened after that? The coast, after a long and exhausting journey, fraught with self-doubt and many tears. The injured settlers, we lost all of our children. Oh. Along with Jeanette's help, found a safe place on the coast to rest and settle down. You can see we're dragging logs, tirelessly trying to survive. We had no other choice. We couldn't go any further. Oh. In many respects, they had reached the brink. Oh no, listen to this. They were at the brink of their sanity, their strength, their resources, and their country. We've gone as far as we can go. However, the sea, always on the move, has a calming effect. That is very true. I live right next to the ocean. And many a time when I have felt upset or distraught, just looking out of our bedroom window onto the waves is just, it really does calm me. Anyway, Jessa looked out into the blue horizon, tried to find a sense of inner peace, and went back to focusing on managing their community. Hey, developers, if you're watching this, focusing is spelled wrong. Okay, so, town hall number 6. So we can now shift plus mouse wheel to zoom in, and I think we're gonna place, well, the fact that we have this is here is not really a good place to put our town hall. So, can we put, that'd be cool if we could put it right up here. But probably not even enough ground, just like in The Sims. I don't know why I'm messing with how important it has to be. It has to be in the exact right place. First of all, let's try turning the camera perfect so we can get a better view. I just feel like my town hall, my home, should be placed with an excellent view of the, ha, perfect. So I'm gonna hold the shift key and the mouse wheel and move in. That's fun, that's awesome. I'm glad they fixed that. Oops, I wanted to zoom. Okay, perfect, yay, town hall time. Enter beleaguered villagers.
The building is finished.
And they are so good at making town halls that they can do it in like 2 seconds flat. So Basalt never wanted any of this to happen. I wish the same thing hadn't happened to you as it did to my people. What do you mean as it did to your people? You didn't tell us this. It's not your fault, Basalt. So Basalt must have been in that village that burned before, or that village that we were just in that was emptied as it was. And he found us in the swamps running away from it. Ah, I see. Sometimes it's a blessing to be able to forget, Benlin. Please help me. What should I do now? Well, Benlin, right now it looks like people are dancing in a weird circle and doing push-ups or something, or... Well, at least the villagers are enjoying themselves. Let's get them to work, though, because we don't have time to enjoy ourselves. We have to get to it. Let's do the same thing as we always do and gather wood. Get to work. Look at them. They're all trudging out like, all right. Gosh. Except for her. She's like, I'm beating it. I'm going swimming. Who is that, by the way? Albina, I should have known it. She's troubled by not having a home. Well, we're working on it. Okay, we've been through so much now, we should stop being so formal with one another. Oh, Benlin, I never knew you cared. A few months ago, you were a suspicious observer, and now you're a valuable friend. Well, I have to admit, he's grown on me a little bit. And that is why I want to advise you to find new strength. Regardless of what has happened, you're still responsible for all your people, and they need your leadership now more than ever. What did my leadership do to them, Benlin? We're standing here now with blood on our hands, hungry and injured. At the edge of the world, and that's all because of me. Oh, come on. Fuck up. Everyone here joined you voluntarily, Benlin tells us. We're all in charge of our own fate, and everyone has their own special job to do. You know what, Benlin? You're kind of wise. Dry, it's very dry. It's only going to get worse. Summer's coming, and it will wear us down. So maybe we need a well or something. Let's try to make the best out of this barren land. Basalt, why are you clapping your hands? The sails! Look where the waves are low! You can see sails! Where? I don't see anything. You see anything? There may be a trade route. Oh, so maybe... Okay. Well, let's get to... I'm going to pause here for a minute and just so I can think. We need to start building. We already have 49 wood. Wow. Go, people, go. Oh, no quests are available. So I guess it's just up to me. I never got to build a sawmill, but Acarius came before we even got a sawmill built. So let's just, build one. Right. Here. Right next to all this handy wood. And I'm going to keep going. And we need some food, so let's do a jetty again. Well, we don't have the wood for it yet. Need 30 wood for a fishing jetty. So people are heading back out. They're building our sawmill. Yay! And that's really neat. That shows us exactly what's going on. How much wood and stone are being used and how much are being built. So that's really neat. So we need 30 for a fishing jetty. We're gonna run out of wood soon. They're really hopping it. Okay, so. Just need to keep the villagers fed. I'm kind of a cruel mistress and I haven't given them a house or anything, but at least they're fed. Although it might not let us fish off the ocean. Looks like it doesn't. Okay, well, I guess we're not getting a fishing jetty. Lots of your settlers have already lost hope in this dry area. Oh, so he's suggesting we build a church. Well, we can do that. A chapel. Okay. Wouldn't a chapel be sufficient? Oh, I see. You can build a bigger church. A larger building than a small chapel. Okay.
New quest.
So, that gives us a church. We need 60, so we better get the iron and stone mine going again. Here's the quarry. Sawmill. Let's get the quarry over here. And then as soon as we have enough stone, we will build the sawmill. I don't know if there's any wildlife here, but we need food, so we're going to have to hope that a... Oh, wait a minute. It looks like we're about to go hungry. Uh-oh, that's a problem. Okay, I'm going to slow this down a little bit. Because I see no way to get food for our people. We can build them houses. We can get them a church. They can gather, but we have no, like the, right here is normally the Hunter's Lodge, and that's not available. Fishing jetty. I'll try again, but... Oh, fishing jetty. I guess I was just not putting it in the exact pixel you needed to be on. Okay, perfect. Problem solved. Okay, you. We need a woodcutter. And that should take care of things nicely. Perfect. That'll keep wood going. We'll also help gather some wood over here for people. Okay. Build a church. We're working on it. We have enough stone, I think, now to build a... Need 30 wood to build, to gather stone, put a stone quarry over here. People are working away here. I love the sounds. And also, it was saying that we needed water.
The building is finished.
And actually, we should probably work on that real quick. Fishing jetty is finished. Let's... Oh, wait, no. Not that building. Was it this building? Yes, stone cutter. Okay, our fishing jetty is coming along. We have plenty of wood. Stone is... We have 10 stone. Do we have enough to build the church yet? Nope. Oh, not even remotely. I think we're wasting a whole lot of resources here.
The building is finished.
And not too short a time, too, because people are very hungry and very thirsty because I have not gotten them a well yet. Let's do a rain catcher here. And get building on that. Basalt comes to tell us that he saw more sales today. Why are you only telling me this now? This could be our chance to turn things around. We could build a port immediately so the ships could dock here. And they'll bring us fresh food, yes!
New quest.
Excellent! So that means that we should get a port. Would that be... Warehouse... Let's see here. Build, create a port. Fishing jetty, sawmill, forge, quarry. I do not see where the port popped up. I'm glad we have a rain catcher though. I should have done that first. Warehouse, church. Yeah, not seeing the port. But at least we have food coming in. Thank goodness. I know everybody's hungry. Look at that. Those signs are all like, I really need to eat. I need to eat. But, we can't really go any farther until... I think I'm going to have to do some more... I think we're running into that problem where all of our villagers are otherwise occupied. So I'm going to do some reallocating and move two people down so they can go and, harvest trees. Our fishermen, we definitely need 2 fishermen, so I'm not going to mess with that. We're barely keeping up with demand as it is. And I'm going to take 1 woodcutter. Suppose I'll keep 2. Once again, going into the villager screen here. See, we have so few villagers. There's only 2 people cutting. No, 4 people cutting. Ah! Oh, wait, no. I got all excited. I was like, yes! No. Not even remotely. Finished. Okay, our rain catcher is finished. Perfect. So that means people will now be able to get water. So water and food are now taken care of. At this point, it's just a waiting game until I can get enough to do a quarry. Still don't have enough wood for a quarry. Gather stone. Just a few more pieces of wood, and then we should be able to put that down. Let's get a nicer view of things. It's a very cute little map. Anyway, I was saying earlier that one of the problems... So let me make sure. Is this the same thing I have as over here? I think it is. That's for stone. But I need... iron, stone. Oh, so it looks like I need iron, and I need 55 wood for that. We're gonna take every tree on this map, it looks like. We're just gonna bald the whole place up. Not a tree to be seen. And there was a complaint, as I was mentioning, that there's not enough maps in the free play. I haven't been in free play yet. But with the rate that they're adding patches, I have hope that they'll continue to add new maps, because having new places to play, there is not a map creator too. That's a big, big thing that the game could use. I imagine that they probably have some sort of... it looks like our sawmill is unable to gather anymore, or full. Ah, full. So let's put someone in the here to add storage. A warehouser. We'll head in here, and I'll take 1 woodcutter away and make you a warehouser, and that should do. So let me know if you have played the free play. Even if you're watching this months down the road, if they have added some maps. Of course, it's always good to let us know. Okay, so... last thing we're working on. Yay! We can finally do our forge. Let's get down here and get that stone. Or am I doing something wrong? Wait. Processes iron into tools. Oh, no, I don't need that. Gather stone. So it says here we need 25... pieces here, but I have no way to get those pieces because the stone gathering thing is not there. Interesting. It's supposed to be here. I don't know if you can see my mouse on the screen. And it also looks like you are full, so I will take you and take your stone cutters down. Okay, well, it looks like we have a small problem because I have no way to gather this stone. I could just gather stone this way, maybe? Oh, okay. Yeah, I feel kind of stupid. All right, there you go. I knew that. Okay. So, things are bleak, but at least we're in a beautiful area. We have some small food, we have water, and we are harvesting the land and denuding it of resources as we are wont to do. We basically head to a new area, pick it dry, and then move on. That's me, Queen Jessa. Enjoying myself. Okay, so I'm going to put this again, episode... episode 4. My computer is not responding. Apologies for that. There was a problem in which my computer stopped responding. Episode 4, maybe it will let me overwrite. And we will head out to the main menu. And in the next menu, in the next episode, where there will also be a main menu, we will finish up. I think the next episode will probably be our last episode of Villagers, because based on the campaign, we have Ship Ahoy and New Hope, so we're halfway through, or somewhat through Ship Ahoy, so things are moving along nicely. And so far, I really, really liked this campaign. The story is very cute. You have to, I suppose, you're not going to expect the highest quality of literary excellence, I think, because the writers were not, English is not their first language. But keeping that in mind, and keeping in mind that it's somewhat dialogue heavy, so a lot of people won't like that, but I'm enjoying it, and I hope you are as well too. And if you are, please hit the thumbs up button below, and if you're loving it, chicken, join the party and subscribe. I'll see you back here for more Villagers in the last and probably final episode of this series. And so yeah, let's find out what happens to the inhabitants of Jessaville. As always, thank you so much for watching.